in the jungle, though. The Cleveland Aikido is deceptively slow, I think, because people expect it to be a lot quicker, but that's Keyboy trying to be a nuisance, getting chunked quite low, and everyone else is on the hunt, trying to find an extra kill, but look at Kyrie.
Oh, he wants to steal. He gets it! With the Retribution, he was able to get the camp, getting more EXP, but lethal will be secured by Tsutsujin. All quiet until then.
I mean, at this point, you can... Oh, wait a minute, Keyboy's taken really low.
Yep, stunned now, still holding on towards his flicker though. Vanstrong already opening vision, taking damage as well. No commitments to invade though.
Back to my point earlier on, I think Onyx, they have a little bit more to work with, especially with the Ling. They should be able to rotate a lot quicker, but in terms of emblems here, anything standing out?
Tenacities, and of course, the Pull Yourself Together and the Inspire for Kryte. He's all utility, but look at Kyrie!
Kryte, no cold altar! Take a look at this fast hands, Kyrie! That's Kyrie Ryo still sold for you, but take a look at bot size, CW! BMI! Keyboy with the cover, CW low on HP, but no! Tsutsujin secures the kill. Almost a great escape there.
Almost, but Sans goes in once again. That's a terrify.
Oh, the trade, looking for the trade. Tsutsujin with the cover. Take a look at the backside though, Cho. Jet Kune Do, no flicker. Oh, he has a flicker! There you go, finding the kill. That's 200 gold for Keyboy.
Oh, but was that a wise decision? Vanstrong already in the vicinity. He doesn't necessarily have level 4 just yet. Tsutsujin is there as well.
Yeah, just buying time here, Keyboy. Take a look at top side. Boots survived the 2v1 as well. And Keyboy!
No way!
No flicker, no problem. He escapes from that situation.
The Cho mobility, so difficult to deal with. Not for Evos. They were able to get a chain of moments right there, but they lost control over the turtle, and now Fluffy gets jumped on.
Oh, let's see. He did it in game one. This time, he won't be able to do it. Kyrie finding the turtle and finding the kill as well. Cold Altar wasted. Suppression comes through. The damage is there. Kyrie finds the kill again. Sans taking ult and shatter onto it. Tsutsujin. No kill for Tsutsujin. Kyrie finds the double. Land strong now, juicy target, triple kill for Kyrie, minute 3.
It's like Onyx just want to go home at this point, right? They're playing messily, but it's working out with how they're able to chain their skills because of the early game damage coming in from Kyrie as well. Look at that, 6-1 in the first 3 minutes of the game. And Papolong, anti-Onyx.
It was the anti-Onyx, the final boss, Pa Pulong.
Can the audience hear the chants?
Audience probably are starting to chant that as well. But man, for Evos, you can see that they have no control whatsoever right here. They're just playing at the whims of Onyx. The cult ult from Kryte was late as well to save Fluffy's life. So a lot of miscoordination, and this is what happens when you change your roster around. But look at this play though.
Flicker Divine Judgment onto its Keyboy though. Take a look at the Jet Kune Do will not survive this time. Keyboy will be taken out. Onyx though, still a healthy lead.
Even in the XP lane, a one level ahead.
Goodness.
Boots on the Edith. And in the jungle, this strong Paquito pick, the fighter against the assassin, still showing right here, right? Level 6 against level 7, despite losing his life once already. For now though, without any neutral objectives, both teams is waiting around looking for plays, but Evos Legends, they are the ones who require to use this Kaja in a more aggressive fashion.
They haven't been able to. There's just so much counter engage coming in from Evos Legends. I mean, from Onyx, what are you supposed to do? Go in Divine Judgment, and let's say there's follow-up coming in from the Paquito. Earth Shatter from Boots can just seal the deal, not to mention Sans can pick up anything they want, but in the top lane, Boots gonna get severely punished here.
Yeah, 2v1, no flicker, so it's a clean kill just before the turtle. Well, I mean, just as the turtle spawns. So let's see here, will they be able to take the domino effect? Seems like, yeah. Not yet though, Keyboy jumping in, Tsutsujin claiming the turtle, but Keyboy will be saved by the Cult Altar. Take a look at the backside here. Both teams popping that Cult Altar. No casualties, only Boots topside earlier.
What a great secure from Tsutsujin there. Despite being equal level, or was he a level below?
He was a level below, got 8 after the turtle.
Well, that's the burst damage from the Paquito for you. He's going with the lethal ignition, by the way, so again, He has a lot of damage in his pocket. The timing for the pick-up on the top side is really, really good. You need to see more moments like that from EVOS if they want to try and bring this game to the late game. Because Kyrie, already 4-0. In the late game, EVOS will rely on brands, and against a 4-0 lane, that's not a fun prospect.
Definitely not, but at least they do still have cover coming in from Kite, and I think that's the point of the Cult Altar and the Faramis, that cover, and even if they want to go for it, they do still have advanced strong. There are layers to these team fights, which is why Onyx has really benefited on going for your pickoffs instead. It looks like they're going for more, looking for a pickoff here as well.
Ooh. Almost. We're Dragon though, connecting onto his Van Strong, and Van Strong will be taken out by CW. Cult Altar out of range, Tempest of Blade in the backside, goes for Cried, Purify pop there. But it seems like no casualties. I might be wrong. Take a look at the damage. Oof. Cried barely survives.
That's dangerous. And yet again, the Cult Altar fails to save the member that is being jumped on by Onyx. It's a repeat again and again. And with Sand and CW pushing together, Bronze wants no business, no part of that whatsoever. Building towards a BOD with the steel leg plates to try and get an edge in the lane against CW. For CW, though, like we said, he's a great weak side player, and still, he has an 800 gold lead. So far, only finishing the Demon Hunter Sword. Corrosion Scythe most likely coming up after. Or Golden Staff, sorry.
Mm-hmm. Let's see what happens here in the mid side. I'm quite curious. Last time, EVOS Legends were able to get a pick off. That's how they've been able to gain control of the neutral objectives. Are they going to go for a 50-50 5v5 this time around? Oh, they're not!
A good pull onto his boots, flickering as a defensive maneuver. Primal Wrath will not be able to mount anything. Facing Duet will silence three members and Tempest of Blade will secure the kill. Fluffy on the side, finding the kill though, finding the shutdown. It's a 2-for-1 for now as Sans gets taken down as well. It's a 3-for-1, EVOS Legends here. They equalize minute 7.
The shutdown onto Kyrie by Fluffy, man. This man, once again, give him an aggressive hero, he will deliver on the aggression department. The tankiness, the fighters, the fighter comp from EVOS Legends allows them to actually sustain through, and the Cult Altar nullifies the Blazing Duet as well. This is how the comp is meant to operate. We'll see if EVOS Legends can pull off similar fights again and again.
And once again, EVOS Legends claiming control over more things on the board, with Sutujin being able to get the turret in that top side, providing more space for EVOS Legends. This isn't clean again.
No. This time not clean. Earlier, I feel like this is drifting from the game plan of Onyx. So, what, Arashi? What happened? Can Onyx bounce back? And if so, what did they need to do?
I think they have to play for CW a bit more. Over in that fight, CW has the basic items, right? The Demon Hunter Sword and the Golden Staff. But it's not enough to burst through a Arlott with a Brave Smite, as well as Sutsujin on that Paquito. So they were able to sustain through it, essentially, and outlive that damage. The longer the game goes, the more EVOS Legends will not be able to do so. But until then, Onyx needs to stay on the pickoff game or on the counter engage game and just try and make sure that they just keep bewildering EVOS using that macro gameplay, using the mobility of the Ling that's 5-1 with a Windtalker, not losing any 1v1s anytime soon.
And that's exactly what Kyrie's been doing. If you notice his rotations on the map, right? He's looking for a little bit of damage here, a little bit of damage there, trying to cut some lanes around the map as well. That's all that they've been able to do, realizing that EVOS Legends, they don't have the mobility to match the Ling with the choices that they made in the drafting phase. But EVOS Legends, despite all that, they've been able to trade back really well, right? With CW being able to take a turn on the top side, you can already see there's pressure there for EVOS Legends. They're looking for that tier 2 turret. They're looking for a pickoff before they go in for these team fights. EVOS Legends, they're doing everything right. If Van Strong gets yet another pick, it's another GG. There you go!
Quick Divine Judgment. Oh, Inter Trunchen! Sans with the read. Now Fluffy will in battle. Brad Boots with a 3-man knock up of the Shadow Blazing Dwarf towards the backside. Sutujin finds the first. He gets the double as Sans is going to get taken down as well. Keyboy will lose his immortal here as Fluffy will be the trade. It's a 3-for-1 all for EVOS Legends.
Those are the cores of Onyx, just obliterated with that team fight coming in from EVOS Legends. You thought that perhaps Sans outplayed the situation with the Winter Truncheon, but look at them grabbing the space, grabbing the objectives on the board. Kyrie focusing on that top turret.
Yeah.
It begs the question, why did Onyx go for a team fight there? Boots going for a multiple man knockup, that was really, really good, but at the same time, it puts
his
team in jeopardy as Kyrie slides out of there. Both him and CW needs to be very careful right now, because otherwise, Brands at this point has quite enough damage. Before you know it, you're going to get bursted down. This is the danger that a Beatrix with the full physical damage build can get you.
You see Kyrie's hands earlier. Goodness, fast hands. But yeah, I mean, they're still behind 3,000 gold with the Lord coming, marching mid. I think they are still able to defend, but question is, how many base turrets will stand?
I don't know, that's a question here. I mean, it is the first Lord, but the problem is Onyx, they don't really have the range to be able to compete against EVOS Legends. Remember, Bronze does still have that ultimate. I guess Onyx can utilize CW, but is it too risky going against the Divine of Judgment?
Well, Onyx will be able to clear the Lord out just now, and Kyrie is positioned behind everyone.
Oh.
A bit of a risky maneuver here. But for EVOS, that's what they want to do, force a team fight. Oh. And look at that, Kyrie gets spotted out, forced to leave the vicinity, and EVOS is back on the hunt. Back and waiting for Vanstrong to just hook one guy down, pull him into the team, and Onyx is just forced to wait for a mistake from EVOS Legends.
And they have the damage to do that, right? You can see that the Beatrix already, Malefic Roar, BOD, Fury Hammer, a lot of damage. What is he going for next?
Ooh. Oh, Flicker Divine Judgment on towards Boots now. He gets insta-deleted. 5v4. Finally, Vanstrong repaired his game from game one. Conceal, oh, canceled immediately by first claw to skill. Take a look at Ling here. Trying to pry out the jungles of EVOS Legends. Very smart.
While this is all going on though, Onyx, they're sending Kyrie off to try and get something else. Trying to go for a bit of a split push, kind of. He's just trying to get farm as much as possible, making use of the mobility. It's the best thing he can do for now. But the wave pushing really, really hard in the top side, building up to be a massive wave. Seems like EVOS Legends want to try and control it before it becomes out of hand. Or they're just trying to just deny Kyrie his purple buff.
Oh.
Good final slash on towards Boots again. Primal Wrath to the backside. Sun Tzu-jin gets taken out. Keyboy finds up Rans, but he will be taken out instead. Called Alter, saving Bronze there. But then again, it's a 1-for-1, no retreat for EVOS Legends.
Fluffy is so insane. What is he on lately? Arlet, Paquito, Uranus. What else has he utilized to just crazy extent? Esmeralda to Rizla. This guy performs so well over and over. EVOS Legends, if consistency is a thing, even if they swap out the rosters, man, Fluffy is sure is consistent with a 4v4 situation. There you go, once again!
Finding two, my goodness, suppression comes through towards Boots. Couldn't not soak the damage. Oh, Sans with the four-man final slash. Luckily for side of EVOS Legends, there's no follow-up. Take a look at Cry.
Oh,
Call of Alter pops, but take a look at Keyboy finding Vanstrong again. Fluffy has Immortal, will lose his Immortal, but Tzu-jin calmly claims the Lord.
Wow, CW, very, very low right there, but still outputting that damage. It's a great move for EVOS to force that fight though, because otherwise Onyx, look at that wave. They haven't touched it and it's pushing on the top side. It would have been a big problem, but they go and deny that chance from Onyx. Left behind in the levels, left behind 2k in the gold. It's not much, but it still counts. And against a Beatrix, now they are in trouble. In these big team fights, they lack the damage to actually pressure EVOS Legends away, and they have no solution for Fluffy just being an absolute menace right here.
Yeah, not just yet. How is he always able to find those openings? And the way that it collapses with one another. I think another shout out needs to go to Vanstrong. I think he's been performing really well as well, getting those Divine Judgments down. And it really banks on that. If Onyx is able to get a pick off first, I think it's going to be in favor of Onyx. If Van Strong gets that important Divine Judgment, GG for Onyx as that Lord marching down in the bottom sit line.
Ooh, that's a cult altar stolen by San, so it can be used, utilized quite effectively to try and defend the base right here. The first tower though gets taken out. Keyboy caught out. That's a final slash down though. So for one base turret, it seems like an okay trade that Onyx is willing to take. Look at Kairi though, never an idle moment.
I mean, again, EVOS Legends, they, I don't know if it's unanimous, but they failed to push three waves. They left the top side unoccupied, which Kairi happily occupied. Keyboy moving. Oh, Flicker.
Oh!
That's a miss mechanic there by Keyboy. Losing his immortal. Cult also now four. Tickle Kairi in the backside. Boots will be taken out. Oh, CW blazing duet. Cult Alter pop though. Kairi, will he survive this one? Keyboy gets taken out. So it's a 2-for-none. Fourth side of EVOS Legends.
Diving a Cult Alter?
Wow.
What were they thinking? Oh, that was so unfortunate. They were, the Cult Alter was stolen from Sans as well, so they were trying to try and match EVOS Legends, but I think Kairi was a bit late to the party as well. He's forced to just dive under the turret. That's dangerous with two members down right here. EVOS, they might be trying to go for more base turrets.
It looks like it. I mean, they're marching down in the bottom lane. Brand's just sieging, just melting through. Kairi might be in trouble against Fluffy here.
Oh. Not for now. Seems like base turret left standing will be the top side of Forge out of Onyx. EVOS Legends, 2,000 gold lead here, minute 17, with the Lord coming. What can Onyx do?
I don't think they can win if the Lord is involved, but let's take a look at the instant replay by the Samsung Galaxy Z series. Keyboy goes for the play, but Van Strong denies it from him, and that is just unfortunate. The Cult Altar was popped to try and salvage the situation, but afterwards, they are forced to engage under the turret with a Cult Altar. That is not the way to go, man. Onyx, they lost two, they lost control, lose one more base turret as well, and then the Lord is being taken by EVOS. But no, Onyx are the ones that have control over the area. EVOS are playing it very patiently macro-wise.
Looking at the situation again, seems like EVOS Legends, why are they hesitating here? Is that the right move, or do you think they should be more active with this momentum that they have established?
At this point, they just have to be a bit more, they have to play a bit reactive. If they go too aggressive, then they risk losing Brands due to the lack of card control whatsoever. Oh. But now, look at that, going in towards Boots, the immobile hero.
Yeah, it seems like they are going for the creative route. Boots now, again, very low. Good way of Dragon to disengage. Fluffy again loses Immortal. Sujin will also be the casualty, perhaps. But no, the Terrify comes through. Boots gets taken out. Take a look at the Crying in the backside, causing
Kairi! Kairi!
Take a look at Kairi! Take a look at Kairi! Onyx gets it with the Windtalker!
Oh, no, no, no!
Oh, wait!
No!
Oh! Kairi Ryos now solo! With the solo push!
And Onyx Esports show what it means to have the experience to have that MSC Championship